everybody. Welcome back. It's fucking season two. We're doing the Peepee Man podcast. It's back, baby.
Yeah.
But we also...
matching shirts.
We're having technical difficulties because fuck the world and the government sucks. And they allow monopolies in internet companies for some reason.
Yeah. I mean, it's technically not a monopoly. You can get like AT&T and stuff out here. It's just that
yeah, I could sucks. Get T-Mobile for 40 and get a fucking 5 megabyte fucking speeds.
Yeah.
It'd be great.
Yeah. But the problem is that it's always up to. So whenever that you're paying for the 1 gig or the 0.5 gig or whatever you're paying for, it's always up to. And they just fuck you.
I know. We got to start a petition where it's like...
stop advertising.
Well, the thing is, if you're going to do up to, you're going to have to put a fucking minimum on it at least. Like, yeah. I mean, if it's going to be 1 gig, you can't say it's 1 gig up to 1 gig and then give me 30 fucking megabytes.
Yeah.
That's ridiculous.
Yeah, that's what I'm getting at, yeah.
You need to put, if you're paying for 1 gig, you at the very minimum get 500. And if you don't get 500, then like you should get some fucking money back, dude.
Yeah, that's what I think is really crazy is you can't like refuse to pay them. Even if that you've had multiple days with no service at all because they've been working on it, you still have to pay them for those days that you didn't use it.
That shit irritates the fuck out of me. Like that's the thing. It's like it's a service just like your fucking water company, your power.
Yeah.
If your power goes out, you're not paying that.
Yeah.
You're not paying for it.
Yeah. Same with the water, whatever you use. That's the thing, too, I think it's crazy is that, you know, you don't pay for what you use on the internet. It's always unlimited now.
Yeah, it's just go fuck yourself.
Yeah. I think that they should do, what they should do is they should say at speeds of between 250 and 500 and you have X amount of total usage that you can use on it. If they're going to do it that way. Because there is still a limit of how much that you can use.
They do have like data.
Yeah.
A data thing. But I always pay for unlimited because, I mean, it's never fucking worth it, but it is for me because I'm just always on the fucking thing. True. So,
fuck the internet companies. Man, so, what do you think about extinction?
I don't know. Give me your thoughts.
So, I've been reading the Jurassic Park novels, and it's kind of changing my perspective a little bit on it. So they're talking about like elephants and stuff in the book. They're like, you know, or the dinosaurs. Like the dinosaurs, they went extinct, and they deserve to be extinct because of societal collapse and blah, blah, blah. They just didn't adapt in time, you know. And extinction is a natural thing. It happens, right? Like,
yeah,
it's always happened. So why are we trying so hard to keep elephants and shit from going extinct? It's a very human and very selfish thing.
See, I think the argument to be made is the, like, obviously the bees, right? The bees is always, like, a huge topic. And it's because, what, they fucking...
they pollinate.
So that's, and they we
do,
need that.
They do, yeah, they help us produce oxygen. They do something that's so big.
That's why we're doing all the Save the Bees thing.
Yeah, I wasn't asking
about the bees. But elephants specifically is like...
think about what we do to these countries that we consider to be third world countries, right? Because here in the West, we consider pretty much all of Africa to be a third world country, except for like Egypt and Morocco.
Yeah, like the places that have money, yeah.
Yeah, but we're telling them like, hey, you guys can't, you know, do ivory trade, which is a very profitable business for them. Can't do that because the animals need to be protected. You got to dedicate all of this land to wildlife preserves instead of turning it into agriculture.
I think it's weird that they would try to listen to us.
Yeah, well, I don't know why.
Are we helping them?
Yeah.
Is that why?
Probably.
We're like sending food to them.
Sending them food, medicine, and whatever. But the thing is it's like, when are we going to let the African countries stand on their own feet and become their own country?
I don't know. Here's the thing, though. I don't know. I think they're content living in mud huts.
I don't think so.
There's 0%. Saving Private, or not Saving Private, right? Fucking, what is that one movie with where the boat, the Somalians take over the boat?
Captain Phillips,
yeah. I mean, they're fucked. I mean, that's the way they live their life. There was no other option other than to go fucking steal the damn boat.
Yeah, I know.
And they're like the people with money.
Yeah.
The pirates.
Yeah. So then that comes back to my question is, when are we going to let them become their own country so that way they don't have to do stuff like that?
I don't know if killing elephants is going to be
No. It's not about the killing elephants. It's about the amount of territory that they have to have set aside for wildlife preserves that they could be using for agriculture. All of the land they have that's like good for growing plants, they're like, no, we have to leave it there for the elephants and for the hippos.
Yeah, that would be crazy. I mean, if they could fucking profit on that, they could actually be a have an economy.
Yeah, have an economy and lift all their people out of poverty and, you know, become a world power. Right now, the only like African countries that are world powers are ones that have had Western countries, you know, dip their toes in and take control. Like, we talk about South Africa. South Africa's been ran by the Dutch forever.
Dude, fuck PETA, man. Yeah. Kill everything. I don't give a fuck.
Well, that's the thing, too, is that I need to specify that that's not where I'm coming from at all on this. I'm not saying, like, you know, fuck elephants. I think they're stupid and they should die.
No.
Because, like, I had this conversation with Lexi, and that's immediately where she went. She was like, why do you hate elephants so much? And it's like, I don't hate elephants so much, but think about how much money we fucking waste. Think about it. We waste so much money on these animals, dude. Millions of dollars.
Saying the word money in that context, though, because now it brings people's brains to life over money.
Yeah. Okay. What's the difference between a cow and an elephant? Why is the life of an elephant worth so much more than the life of a cow? You've been through Midland, Texas and seen it, dude. It's nothing but cow
less of them.
Oh, so that's what
it's
it
exotic.
Is?
Exotic.
It's exotic. It's special.
Yeah.
It's stupid.
No, I'm saying like, you're saying how much money are we wasting?
To keep the elephants alive.
Yeah, not killing the fucking elephants. It's like, is money worth anything? That's my question.
No, it's not.
I don't give a shit about money.
Yeah, we spend more money to kill the cows that we grow than we do to try and save the elephants. And the cattle is destroying the environment. It's producing methane, it's creating giant holes in the ozone layer, they're eating up all of the grass and all of the fields. Like,
you know what? The methane thing.
Cow farts, bro.
Motherfucking shit's gonna fart, bro.
I know that, but the problem is that we're creating stuff that's not natural, where we produce so many cows and we get them all in one spot. It's not like that we're just like, oh, all these squirrels that are farting in the trees and fucking...
I've heard different things, too. I've heard that we're not fucking with the ozone layer at all, too.
Yeah, I've heard that from people who literally have no idea what they're talking about, and they don't look at any evidence. They just look at the sky, and they're like, yeah, sky's still there. These are the same people who are all like, we live in a firmament. You know, people think they live in a fucking snow globe.
Yeah. Dude, I don't know, man.
I just think that it's weird, and I think it's a very human thing. Because, like, the other thing is we talk about that we're destroying the planet.
To be honest with you, dude, after I'm dead, I could give a fuck if the entire human race dies.
Yeah.
I don't give a shit.
Yeah.
Like.
Yeah.
I don't know. I mean, that's a horrible thing to say, I guess. I honestly don't give a fuck.
I think it's perfectly normal for people who don't have kids, though. Like, that's the thing. It's like, I have a slightly different outlook because that the world that I leave behind is the one that my kids have to live in, right?
Yeah.
But, like, I don't give a shit if that the only place my kid sees an elephant is in the zoo, because that's the only place he's going to see it in the zoo anyways. It's not like I'm going to be like, hey, Gideon, we're going to Africa. We're going to go to Kenya, and we're going to go to the wildlife preserve. Aren't you psyched? We're going to go see an elephant? And he's going to be like, no, because I just saw an elephant at the fucking zoo, and it was 10 times cooler because I was able to feed it leaves, and I got a soda pop when I was there. I didn't get attacked by lions.
I'll tell you what, man. There's some fucking weird animals out there.
Giraffes.
What the fuck is that? That's legit what I was picturing, man.
Yeah.
What is that?
I don't know.
What the fuck? What is the purpose of that, though?
They say it's evolved because of, like, the acacia trees. So it has to get a long neck to be able to get up and get to the food.
So what is it? It was a fucking llama? Something and it like just that. Was like...
I think it's like... I think that they're like in the deer family.
Dude, imagine just fucking... reaching your neck out
so much that
your neck actually stretches over time.
That's not how that happens.
No, but like the next generation.
That's not how that happens.
Is that it?
No. What happens is that the ones that are born with longer necks naturally.
Oh, they then survive. The other ones die out. Okay, yeah. I got you.
So it's not like that. You just fucking you just keep stretching your dick, dude, and then your kids are gonna have 20-inch dicks. You know,
dude, I can't believe I actually thought that. That was so weird.
Yeah, I can't believe you actually thought that either. It's funny.
Like, if motherfuckers just stretching their neck, and then the next generation has a longer neck. That's legit what I just thought.
No, it's what it is. Fuck? Is it's like you know. So think about it like humans. Like
the lucky ones.
The lucky ones that are 6'7" that get to go and play basketball, you know?
Yeah. Dude, I thought about that the other day, too. You know, some people are just born, like, good.
Yeah.
Like, and that's a tough gig. Because if you're not, that's a fucking tough gig, bud.
Yeah, but, like, the thing is that even though if you're born good, you still have to work so hard for it, too, you know? It's not like that.
Well, I'm saying LeBron there's some James. People who are born with normal human minds that don't, like, that produce a normal amount of dopamine.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? That to me is uncomprehensible to me. Like, I don't even understand that.
Cheat codes, bro.
I don't think it's a real thing. It's like, I thought everybody, I mean, legit, like, they fucking train you as a kid to, like, you know, you're unique in your own way, but, like, you fucking are the same.
Yeah.
But no.
You're not.
No, you're not. Not a fucking single person thinks like I do.
Yeah.
It's fucking stupid, man.
You know, all people are unique in their own little retarded ways.
It
you know?
Sucks, bro.
Yeah.
Like, 99% of the time, it sucks.
Yeah, it does. And it's weird, too, because it's not just the birth thing. It's environment thing, too. Like, if you'll see somebody who comes from a family where the family is a successful family, you'll see the kid making better monetary decisions than you will if you have, like, a very unsuccessful family. You got trailer trash. The kids are going to be trailer trash. You know what I mean?
It's that hard does to get suck out of, too, yeah.
It's hard to get out of that generational thing because you just, your whole way that you approach the world and the way that you understand how things should work is so flawed fundamentally because of your upbringing.
I think it's more like what you're comfortable in, you know?
Yeah, but that's what I'm saying is like, let's say that you spend every day living in a single wide trailer with no AC, right? And you live in Florida. So you're used to like 80, 90 degree weather and you're just built different.
And then 3 months pass and you're living in a mansion. Yeah. It's 60 degrees.
Yeah, and you'd be unhappy.
Yeah.
Yeah. But the thing is that it's like the people who are content with that, they can get by on less. You know, like these are the people who are living under the bridges that are all like, I've got a nice box and it keeps the wind off of me and that's nice. That's nice. You know?
I'll tell you what, man. If I was homeless, I would move to the beach.
Yeah, like if I'm going to just live anywhere, and they're
just
because
they got free showers, and like, it just feels. I feel like it's better to be a bum there.
Well, I know in Jacksonville, if they catch a bum at the beach, they take him downtown and drop him off.
Shit!
Yeah, you're not allowed to be a bum at the beach.
That sucks.
Yeah,
I feel like you could get away with it though, because how are they gonna know?
If you got like a shopping cart full of fucking garbage that you're pushing around,
don't do that. You live at the beach.
Yeah,
don't do that.
Just get a fishing pole.
You don't need money?
No.
No worries, dude. No shoes, no shirt, no problems.
No.
Dude, get a fishing pole? Yeah, that would be bussing. You just wake up every day, go fishing.
Catch
that's what
fish.
You fucking eat.
Or you could just go sell them.
Yeah, or you could sell them and fucking get a burger at McDonald's. Like,
yeah.
That's the life, man.
I've always thought about that, dude. You know, just like quitting my job and go fishing full time.
That's free living, dude.
I wish that you could make money on it. It's
stress-free.
Yeah.
I'm just kidding. There's always stress.
Yeah, because you're like, man, I got to land this fish or else I ain't going to eat tonight.
Yeah, if I don't get a fish, I'm like, well, I haven't got a fish in 3 days. I might die.
I'm hungry.
And
I'm
also, hungry. Like, there's cops here.
Yeah.
I don't know.
You know. The cops are like, hey, man, you've been fishing in this same spot for 3 days. It's a little peculiar. You want to let me count the amount of ribs on that fish you just ate?
Sure.
That's too many. You're going to prison.
Imagine you like catch a fucking like you're like on the beach, right? But you catch like a fucking tuna.
Yeah.
Like an actual tuna, like a big one.
That'd be crazy.
How much do they sell for? Like $1 billion?
I have no idea.
I think they sell for like $100,000 a piece. Like,
I
honestly
don't think that they're that much.
They're,
you can get a can of tuna for 99 cents.
They're a lot, though. It's like, they're expensive fish. I know that.
Yeah, I think a full-size one's probably like 20 grand. I don't know. Let me look.
It's crazy. I mean, how many cans of tuna can you get out of that? Like a billion? But still. It's a fucking lot.
They go for $8 to $15 per pound.
Oh, yeah. How fat, how big is like a full-size tuna? Like how much do they weigh?
up to 400 pounds.
So yeah, that's a gold mine, dude.
Yeah, it's like, what, like...
I mean, so 8 to 15. So just do 10 times 400.
That's $4,000 for a fish.
Yeah,
it's not bad.
It's pretty good.
Pretty good, especially if you catch one a day.
Yeah, I mean, you won't off the beach. You're never catching a tuna.
No,
but
it's no. Right. But you'll catch. You can probably catch a tuna from a good pier.
Really?
I think so.
I think they're like way out there. I think you gotta. I think like you can catch tuna from piers. They catch them in like big nets.
No.
Off of, like, fucking oil derricks.
No.
Tuna's, like, tuna is a school fish, right?
They're no.
Oh.
Yeah, you can catch a tuna from the shore. Juveniles come up by the shore.
No shit.
Yeah.
Yo, I'm going tuna fishing. Boy.
I mean, it doesn't surprise me. You catch big-ass sharks from the shore.
You know how many people in the 1800s just fucking gave up their entire lives to go mine, or like, not mine, but like, panhandle for
yeah.
gold?
Yeah, I know, right?
Yeah. They could have just gone tuna fishing, dude.
Yeah. Have you ever read Old Man in the Sea?
No.
You should read it. It's a good book.
Have you read...
No.
10,000 Leagues Under the Boop?
A long time ago. I don't barely remember it.
I never read that. I don't read. But I did read this one book about, like, a fucking manta ray and, like, it's some dudes who fucking try to get pearls.
From manta rays?
No. So they're, like, they're divers and they're just trying to get pearls. And then there's this, like, big-ass manta ray that, like, fucks with them.
Hmm.
And I think he fights it and kills it.
Jesus.
It's fucking weird.
Yeah.
But it was cool. I remember that from fucking reading it when I was like 8, so. Something.
I have to check that out.
Good luck finding it. Shit,
I'm
boy.
It up right now. Pearl divers fight a manta ray.
Pearl diver manta ray fighter.
Pearl diver manta ray.
What is it called? 10,000 Leagues Under the Sea.
A children's book about a man, a manta ray, and a pearl.
That's probably it.
It's a book called The Black Pearl by Scott O'Dell.
Dude, read it. How long is it? Like 4 pages?
It says it's for 8th graders.
Read that shit.
Yeah.
I bet it's trash.
Probably is.
But, hey, I remembered it.
He's like, I pull out my katana from my fucking butthole, and I'm stabbing at this fucking fish.
There's another one that I read. I guess I'll just tell you all the books that I've read. I've only read, like, 4 books.
So. Okay.
There's a World War II book. I think it's called Under a War-Torn Sky.
Nice.
Would recommend. It's fucking good. And it's, like, it's a historic fiction. So it's not a true story that happened.
Yeah, it's like Anne Frank.
Like, there's real things in the book, right?
Yeah.
Anne Frank?
Is it the diary? Real thing that happened. I thought the diaries of Anne Frank were, like, half real, half not real. I thought they were exaggerated.
I don't know. I thought that would be weird.
I thought they were made to be, like, for kids to read.
She didn't actually live in a wall and have a diary?
No, I'm sure that she did, but I think that they dressed it up.
Oh, okay. I thought you were about to tell me that I was living in a fucking loony world. Anyway, Under a War-Torn Sky, this dude, he's like a fucking pilot, or he's, I don't know, but...
Okay, no, and it's, yeah, they were fully written by her.
Yeah. I'm sure there's some fucking weird delusional shit. I mean, she lived in a wall forever, so I'm sure there's some weird fantasy
shit. No, not like that. Not like that. I just thought that somebody took their actual diary and then just, like, yassified it and made it so kids could
read. She actually didn't live in there for that long, right? Like, 3 days?
Yeah, I don't know. I don't know anything about Anne Frank.
I think it was, like, a very short period of time.
Nice.
And she got found.
Damn.
Yeah. And, like, I don't know how the diary got out. That's fucking weird.
Yeah, it's crazy. What happened to Anne Frank? Let's look.
She got fucking murdered, dude.
No.
Yes, she got found and murdered.
She died from exhaustion.
Oh, I could have sworn. She just died in the wall.
No. Like in she was in a train going to a concentration camp, it looks like.
She did get found, though.
She got found?
Okay, right on. So that was close.
Yeah.
That was close. Anyway, under a war-torn sky, he fucking is going, American soldier, he's going over there. World War II, freaking binks on a bong. He, like, jumps out of his plane. I don't know if it gets shot down or something. Breaks his ankle on, like, on the landing.
Yeah.
And then, like, a bunch of people, like civilians, help him get back to America. But he doesn't actually make it back. He's like a POW at some point.
Yeah. Did you ever play Medal of Honor Frontline?
No.
That's such a good game. I was really big into World War II stuff when I was younger. And
I like it a lot.
I thought it was cool because I watched the movie A Bridge Too Far, which if you've ever seen, it's a really good movie. You should watch it. It's like 3 hours long, but you should watch it. It's really good. It's got young Sean Connery in it.
Oh, it's crazy.
Yeah.
What is it? Fucking black and white movie?
No. No, it's from the 70s.
How old is he? He's dead.
He's not dead, I don't think.
He's fucking 90.
I think he is like 90, but he might be dead. I don't know. Let me look.
Sean Connery, he's James Bond before the James Bond we have now.
And he was like one of the original James Bonds.
The OG James Bond.
Yeah. He starred in 7 James Bond films. Yeah, he died in 2020.
Yeah.
Got COVID.
Oh, that sucks.
I don't know.
Dude, I'll tell you what, man. I think half the fucking deaths were like staged.
Oh, yeah.
In 2020.
I don't know. I
it's insane how many famous people died in 2020.
Not really.
It's probably the same exact amount. They were just all posted up like it was the fucking Hunger Games.
Yeah. Well, there was nothing else that was going on. You know, there was nothing else that was going on. So when people were dying, everybody was like, oh, my God, I've been sitting at the house for a week doing nothing.
Oh, now we got bees.
Sean Connery died.
The fucking, I can't even remember all the shit that happened.
Yeah, I don't know.
I do remember, like, fucking gaining 1,000 pounds.
Yeah.
Did that. Still doing that.
Still feeling the repercussions from COVID.
Yeah. Fucking hell. Dude, name 3 things that The Simpsons predicted.
I have no idea.
Go.
Trump as president, I know, is one of them.
They predicted that?
Yeah.
They've predicted everything, dude. Yeah. It's bullshit, man.
Not really. Most of the stuff that you see is bullshit. Like, most people posting it are like,
okay,
it's stuff that happened after the fact,
and they're
making social commentary, and everybody's like, oh, The Simpsons. Well, the thing
is, that's what I thought, too, because I was like, there's 0% chance they predicted any of this.
Well, I mean, they predicted Trump running for president, but everybody thought he was going to run for president.
That kind of makes sense. You could predict that.
Yeah. I think it's funny that it's the same guy that was on fucking Home Alone 2. Kid in the city, you know, he goes up to Donald Trump and he's like talking to Donald Trump. He's like, hey man, how do I get up to your tower? You remember that? I'll put it in post.
Excuse me, where's the lobby?
Down the hall and to the left.
Thanks.
All right, boy. What's song of the week, boy?
Oh man, I don't know. Give me a second.
Like half our conversations are going to dud zone.
No. I don't know, man. You want to just do like something you've been listening to?
Sure. First song of the week of the year. No stipulation.
So I got one. It's an old song that I loved and I've just recently been revisiting it. It's called Bonnie the Cat and it's by Porcupine Tree.
Thank you.
Tell you what, man. They are weird.
I like them.
They have a weird sound.
I like the sound a lot.
It kind of sounds like Deftones and...
Wow.
Fucking... somebody else mixed together.
That's only like this song that sounds like that too. They sound completely different on most of their stuff.
I've looked them up before and been like, oh yeah, I don't like them.
Oh, they usually sound very like Pink Floyd-y.
I remember the first time I heard their name and I was like, oh yeah, I do like them. I'm going to look them up just to make sure. And then I was wrong.
Yeah, I like
so,
them.
So I don't know.
They're not usually metal at all. This is just like one of the weird songs where they up the distortion on the guitar a little bit.
Yeah, they hit a lot of vocal effects too on that one. Let's see. Recently, I've been listening to Brand New again.
Nice.
But, dude, there's like, you got to look up the lead singer of Brand New because I think he did some fucking weird, like, thing that would get you canceled.
Is this one of those guys that had like...
It's probably like something to do with like underage girls or something.
Well, there was one of them I know. He got caught by having them his fans send fucking pictures of their babies.
Oh, that's weird. Like for a sexual thing?
Yeah.
Mm. Can't say it like that very much.
I don't see anything bad in here.
Oh, I thought it was like a known thing. Who's the lead singer of Brand New?
Jesse Lacey.
You've probably got the new guy. I don't know. But anyway.
Yeah, he was the best known as the lead vocalist and rhythm guitarist for the American alternative band Brand New. It's the only one that says.
Oh, well, I didn't hear it. I only heard it. I was at like my social media class. And they were all like, yeah, the leads are Brand New. Sucked off a dude and farted.
Huh. I don't see anything about it.
What do you think about Drake's wiener?
Don't know anything about that either.
Did you see it?
No.
He fucking released it.
Good for him.
A long time ago.
Yeah. Well, it must have been in response to like the hot sauce thing.
It was either Drake or somebody else.
Pretty sure it was Drake.
Yeah. I Show Speed, also, wienered.
Cool.
On the internet.
Nice.
Good for him. All right. Two people wienered. All right, we're going to do probably their most popular song ever. I Believe You, But My Tommy Gun Don't. Nice. Name that movie. You don't know the movie? It's called The Mask.
Mm.
Pretty sure that's right.
Cool.
All right. Oh, you know what? The best part of the song is the very end. Anyway. Here we go. What do you think about his high-pitched, screamy bullshit?
I like the way that they produced it.
I fucking love it.
Because it clipped out. You heard how it clipped out really, really hard. Mm-hmm. So it sounded to me like they had like an older microphone and they put it like right in his fucking gullet like this and it's just clipping.
I figured you would think it was the cringiest thing you've ever heard.
I think it was cringy, but I still think the production was good.
I love it. I don't know why. Something in the way she moves.
He's just a 13-year-old boy.
I don't know, man. There's something about it. It's like... I mean, fucking Third Eye Blind does it in like half of their songs, and I fucking eat it up.
I know, you love vocal dynamics.
Suck it.
Yeah.
Suck it right up.
Yeah, man, Porcupine Tree does some really good vocal dynamics.
Dude, yeah, but they also fucking do some poop.
No.
Let me tell you.
I'm about
the fucking Deftones
You don't like the Deftones?
Are trash.
Nah.
They've never been good.
That's crazy. I like a couple of their songs.
People like them, but they suck ass. I don't know.
I like Tempest. Tempest is
I've
really
never
good.
Liked a single song. And I was like, hey, anybody, give me a song that's good from the Deftones. And they were like, what is that fucking one? Starts with
Change
a P.
The House
like,
of Flies.
It's got like a horse. It's like a horse and it's, it starts with a P. It's called
White Pony.
Yeah, sucks.
What's the name of the album?
Whatever. I think it's like Pale Rider or something. But I don't know. It sucks ass.
Yeah. Sorry to hear that.
Yeah.
We're wearing matching shirts.
Dude, what's your favorite kind of bean?
Okay. Hard, because I really like garbanzo beans, but they're not like really a bean, you know what I mean? Like, I wouldn't put them in a chili.
Mm-hmm.
But I do like black beans a lot.
Do you like a baked bean?
No, I like a black bean.
I know, black beans are the best bean.
They're so good.
100% the best bean. That's on a top five ranking of beans. Black bean is number one for me.
Where does, like, what's number two? Like a pinto?
I would say...
Or a dark red kidney?
I think pinto bean is the... you know the borrachos? Borracho beans?
No.
I don't know what they are. They're probably borracho beans, but you can get them at like Mexican restaurants.
Mm-hmm.
It's borracho instead of refried. Those are good.
Nice.
I haven't had those in a long time.
Probably pinto beans.
Yeah, it's probably pinto beans.
You like limas?
Yeah, I do. I actually really like lima beans.
Love lima beans.
Yeah.
And butter beans too. The big yellow limas.
Yeah, there's some good beans out there.
What about navy beans?
No.
You don't like navy beans?
I don't think I've ever had them.
You like black-eyed peas?
No.
Okay, because navy beans are basically black eyes.
Oh, okay. Dog shit.
Yeah.
So I guess I would go black bean pinto and then fucking like baked beans, like regular baked beans, which are just pinto beans, right?
They're that or red kidneys.
Yeah.
I like kidney beans.
I can't say I like kidney beans.
No, you don't like chili?
I do like chili with the kidney beans in it. But just straight kidney beans? I don't know.
That's yeah. Yeah. You know, they put it in teas in Taiwan. You get like a boba tea, but instead of having the little tapioca things in it, it's got red beans.
I was talking with Levi, and he was like, yeah, what's your favorite bean? He literally asked me that. And he said that he likes a baked bean. Like a baked bean. And what the immediate picture that popped up in my head was like a bean the size of a baked potato.
Nice. The big bean.
And I legit was like, what is a baked bean? Nice. Because my thought process was bean, like bean baked potato. And then I'm like, when have I ever saw a bean? I mean, this is the shit that's going on in my head. When have I ever seen a bean that size? And then I'm thinking, what bean would that be?
That'd be rough.
And then I'm just like, then I back check. I'm like, I would never seen a bean that size. Yeah. And then I was like, what is a baked bean? I mean, that's where my mind led me. But I should have, instead of saying, what is a baked bean, not said anything and back check again and been, oh, I know what a fucking baked bean is. I mean, Jesus, dude.
You know what a Boston baked bean is?
No.
It's a peanut. It's got a hard candy shell on it. It's really good.
Anyway, we should make a giant fucking bean.
Yeah, I don't know how.
And you could just cut it open, put some butter in it.
Bean.
It's a fucking good bean, dude.
Ew.
That's one big bean.
Sounds so gnarly.
I think it would be awesome, actually.
You think so?
Yeah. What about peas? You like peas?
No, not really.
I would eat a fucking pea out of a dog's ass.
I used to like peas a lot. I used to get the wasabi peas, the dried ones, and chew on them.
Dude, tell me a story.
Okay. Once upon a time, there was a man who had to shit really bad.
I know. You start a podcast, and I have to shit.
I always have to shit.
Fucking ass face. No, go shit and come back.
No, let's just do the thing.
It's fucking, you got like 20 Wait, minutes. I got to cut half minutes of this because you fucking got a shit for the whole time.
No. I'm good. I'm holding it in.
Holding in a shit.
I got a strong sphincter. I'll tell you that. I've been doing the exercises.
Oh, you know what? I'll tell you a story. I was at my dad's house the other day, and I shit my pants.
Yeah?
Yeah. And I covered it up pretty good. Yeah, man. It's tough. Have you ever, like, fucking thought you shit your pants, but, like, sucked up the shit fast enough that it didn't actually touch your underwear?
Yeah.
What the fuck is that?
I don't know.
How do you suck a shit up your ass? What the fuck?
The same way that those ladies on the internet smoke cigarettes with their butt.
How is there suction power from your asshole?
Because your sphincter.
I don't understand that. It's not muscles. It's like muscles. A breathing thing.
It is muscles.
They pull it in with air. I mean, the motherfucker's already out of your asshole. It's not like it can reach out.
Yeah, it's only out halfway, and then the muscles in it are like, nope, retract. Yeah. Imagine that, dude. It's like the vault door opening for fucking Fallout.
Yeah, dude. Fucking. That's some porn right there. You shit and you almost. And then you have to pull it back in.
I mean, you can find the prolapse.
Guarantee that's out there.
Yeah, you can find plenty of prolapse porn, dude, where the whole butt comes out and then it goes back in.
Jesus Christ.
Why does that stuff exist?
Their whole butt comes out.
Their whole butt comes out. I'm just like, okay, like, don't get me wrong, man. Like, I'm a gooner, you know what I mean? I've been down the porn rabbit hole.
Gooner. Like,
yeah. But
yeah.
But what the fuck is the deal with prolapsing?
I don't know. Dude, the thing is, man, we're always trying to figure out why animals do things. And then on top of that, I don't think they actually think about what the fuck they're doing. So if they don't know what they're doing, how the fuck are we going to know what they're doing?
Yeah, well, I mean, what they're trying to do, they're trying to read into the animal's actions more so than their thoughts. You know what I mean? We're not trying to figure out what the animal's thinking when it goes into it. We're just trying to figure out what triggers it. That's how animal studies work. Like, people who are...
I want to know what they're thinking.
I don't think you can, because I don't think that they think like we do.
Like, if a cat's looking at me in the face, is it thinking about, like, eating me? Or is it thinking about, like...
I don't think it's thinking on those scales.
It's not thinking at all. It's just looking at me.
It's just like, that's a big guy.
What the fuck?
Yeah. I mean, it's the same way...
How do you look at something and not think about anything?
I mean, we do the same exact thing. Do you see a bird on the side of the road? You don't, like, I'm going to cook that thing. I'm going to pull its feathers off and fucking slurp it down.
When I see a bird close to me, I'm always like, oh, that motherfucker's going to come peck me in the head.
Yeah. That's what I'm saying. You just have a very minor thought. It's not like...
Yeah, you're right. Okay. That's weird.
Yeah, that's just how being alive works.
Fuck that.
Yeah, fuck being alive.
But I would also like to... I'm always back and forth on the fence on, like, can animals have complex thoughts like that we do?
I don't think so. I don't think I'm really on the fence on that. I think that they can't, like...
So they just live and literally have, like, they just live.
Yeah.
Are alive.
Yeah.
They're alive.
Yeah.
With no... nothing.
Yeah, I don't think that cat dog's out there planning on how to get a 401k, you know, I don't...
Just brain dead.
I don't think she's brain dead. I think she's just like, it's time to relax. It's time to
lay in the sun. But I'm saying, like, okay, she wakes up and she's like, man, I gotta go get some food today.
Yeah.
Or no, she wakes up and is just chilling and then is like, my body is telling me I'm hungry.
Both. I think it's both. Because, like, cats can plan. They can make, like, traps and stuff. You know what I mean? Like, they're smart. But it's not like... They don't have, like, complex thoughts. Like, you can't teach cat dog how to work on a engine. No amount of teaching can teach.
They can teach monkeys how to do it.
Some. But they can't really fix them. They only have, like, the intelligence of a 5-year-old.
You can teach monkeys how to communicate.
You don't have to teach them how to communicate. They can already communicate.
I'm like, with us.
Yeah, they do sign language.
That's fucking crazy.
They're about as smart as a 5-year-old. That's what I'm saying. It's like, you can communicate with Gideon.
That is insane.
You know what I mean?
You fuck a monkey?
No. Too hairy?
Okay.
If you shaved one, maybe.
Big shave a monkey guy.
Yeah, I want to look that up right now. I'm going to look up a shaved monkey.
Shave the whale. Shave the whale campaign.
Boy, I don't like that at all. He looks like one of the guys that works at the tire shop down the road from my house.
All of his skin is just ball sack skin.
I know, but look how fucking ripped he is.
He's fucking yoked. I mean, body fat percentage, 1. That's just what they just shave monkeys now.
I get. I don't know.
What the fuck?
There's a bunch of pictures. I looked up shaved monkeys.
Why are they shaving monkeys?
They get hot, I guess.
All right. All right, time for your shave.
Yeah. Come on, Pongo. Get up on the table.
Entire body.
Dude, imagine shaving his balls.
Fuck, yeah. That's great.
Yeah. You're like, man.
Pilot grape.
Yeah. I do that. One of the games I play every time I get on, it comes up and it says, great, as soon as you open it.
Great.
And then every time I'm like, great. And Lexi's like, what are you talking about?
Dude, the funniest shit I ever come across the internet.
Yeah.
Dude, some of my favorite videos are that one, and then, like, obviously, like, the fucking, what do you want to say to Joe Byron right
yeah,
now?
Yeah,
yeah. Love that one.
I really like the ew, brother, ew.
I hate that shit.
I love that one.
And it's like, I feel like you're kind of late on it.
Yeah, I am.
Like, it's been a fucking, it's been out for a while.
I don't use TikTok and stuff like that, so.
Okay.
You know?
Yeah, but, like, it's not just you. I've noticed that the Smite Party has been doing it, too. Recently.
Oh, I love it.
And, like, I've seen this thing and got over it, like, months ago.
It's been a while since I've seen anything that's gotten me interested. I don't know. I think it's just a me thing, though, lately. I've just been so uninterested in everything. Like, games don't do it for me anymore. I don't know. I'm going to be 30 soon, though, so.
So what? It's over for you?
I don't know. I mean, like, maybe maybe it's just natural that my body is, like, my brain is, like, trying to get away from this stuff. You know what I mean? Maybe.
What, the internet?
Yeah. I don't know
about that.
It's not like I'm fucking going out of my way to not get on Facebook. I'm on Facebook every day. I'm just saying, like, I just don't enjoy games, and I don't enjoy scrolling through TikTok, and I don't enjoy, like, I like YouTube. I'll watch the fuck out of some YouTube, but I'd be watching all kinds of stuff on there. I just recently restarted my religious teachings classes. I haven't done them in a while, so.
I never had a YouTube addiction until now. Now it's like, holy shit.
Yeah.
Like, if you saw how much I'm on YouTube, you'd probably be like, holy fuck.
I know. The stuff you watch, too, is weird to me.
It's all over the place, too.
I watch video essays. That's one of my favorite things. It's when you got somebody who puts out, like, a three-hour
video. I mean, half
video.
The shit up there is baseball stuff, though.
Yeah.
So, there's one gaming guy that I like that's, like, MLB The Show, and then there's this one guy that I've been really watching, and he's kind of a fucking dick. And so that turned me off of his content for a long time. But recently, I've been watching a lot of it because he's a major league pitcher, and he mics up on the mound, and he posts that.
I wonder if that's legal.
He plays for the Mexican leagues now, so I'm sure it is. But he mics up on the mound, and he records on the mound. I mean, I don't know what the fuck.
He's like, okay, come in.
Like, he has, like, a drone. There's a drone overhead recording of him doing it. It's fucking weird.
It's pretty cool. What if the drone got nailed by a ball? Tough gig.
Yeah, just get another one. I'm sure he's fucking rich. Millions of dollars for playing in the MLB.
Do you think that somebody who's in the Mexican League makes more money than somebody who's in the women's major league?
Yes.
Probably, yeah.
Yeah.
I don't think women...
There's no women major league athletes. Baseball.
There is.
I would say no.
WMLB?
No, that's not a real thing. No, softball.
No, there was one, but it only existed from 43 to 54. And it was founded by Wrigley.
A League of Their Own. You seen that?
No.
Tom Hanks. It's a good movie. He manages a women's baseball team. Sports. Sports ball.
I don't know, man. I'm big into racing more than I am into any other sports.
You don't like the blitzball thing that I've been watching on YouTube?
No, I don't like blitzball. I told you that.
You watched it and you didn't like it?
I didn't. Yeah, I think it's weird.
Oh, it's fucking awesome.
I just don't like the sport.
It's so competitive.
Yeah.
You have to swing different. Yeah. Oh, dude, you know what? I fucking went out swinging.
Yeah.
With my dad the other day. And I barreled one up. And it was a grounder. Probably a ground out straight to second.
Nice.
But it felt good off the bat. It was the only one that felt good off the bat. But yeah. I'm getting better.
Hell yeah, dude.
Fucking fucking, yeah, just watching videos about swings, watching videos about throwing. So.
Hell yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, I don't know. I'm really big into the watching the racing and building the RC cars right now. That's really been my big thing. Been having a lot of fun. I got this Armor Granite. It's a little two-wheel drive. It's that one that I built out of scraps, you know? And I've been just having a blast with the boys with it, man. We go out inside and do a little circle track. You know? It's good fun.
Good fun.
It's good fun.
It's good fun. What did Nate get? What car did he get?
It's a brand I've never heard of called Really, and it's a Dune Fighter, but it looks pretty sick.
All right, does he tell you how fast it was?
I think it's like 25, 30 miles an hour, which is like, you don't need anything faster than that if you're just driving in your backyard, because then you're like, oh, I'm at the corner. Oh, I'm at the corner. Oh, I'm at the corner. So, I don't know. He likes it, though, and it looks really cool. So, it doesn't turn very good. But he, I guess he got the car for free, or he bought it off of his wife's brother. Something like that.
What do you think his name and his kid?
Oh, I have no idea.
First,
they won't tell me.
First bet.
They won't tell me.
What do you think, though?
I wanted it to
got to call it right
I
now.
I tried to push him to go Manfred.
Manfred?
Yeah.
Hmm. I'm sure that his wife is going to have, like, a significant call in this one.
Yeah.
And I don't know her at all, so I'm...
Doofenshmirtz.
That lowers the chances of me getting it.
What's a German name?
I know it has to be a German name.
Claus.
What is her father's name?
I don't know.
That's the real thing.
Ben.
So if it's Ben, she's going to name him...
Ben Doiken.
Bongus.
Yeah, Bongus.
I'll say they're going to name him Nathan Rowe the second.
No, I bet it's Michael.
It's Nathan Jr. All right. Well, that's episode 1 of season 2. Welcome back. If you like the fucking shit, fart, piss, and cum.
Yeah, don't forget to piss and cum.
Yeah, make sure you piss and cum. The piss button's here. The cum button is also over here. Or the piss button's over here. Cum's over here.
Yeah.
So make sure you definitely cum. You can piss. Piss would be great, too. But cum for sure.
Yeah. Whatever you do, do not shit.
Don't shit.
We don't have a receptacle.
We don't have shit receptacle. Bacon cream pies in your mom's eyes. Bacon cream pies all the time.
Anybody see my shoes?
I hate tomatoes, but I love ketchup.
Can't find it. I'm looking everywhere.
Thing, and it's not even true.
Please, I have to drive home.
I think about you. I have to say,
I had an edible
earlier.
It was
hard to leave you alone.
I think I'm gonna shit my pants.
Please, God, help me leave you alone.
Your mom, Jeremy.